Second Ezra's 2:44.
Like we were saying, we're going to go into the word, because it says, read that part over again. These are they that what put off the,
He said, he answered and said to me, these be they that have put off the mortal clothing.
Yeah, these are they that what put off the mortal clothing, man. All right? That's why, when you read about the scriptures, man, this beautiful lesson just popped in my head. But you're going to look up the word mortal.
This is mortal.
Uh-huh.
This is the dead definition.
Uh-huh.
Liable to death.
Uh-huh.
Mortal.
Yeah, liable to death. So if you're mortal, was there any more to that?
No.
Click it again. Go to the Strong's.
The Strong's. Liable to die.
Right. So click it. Click on the other word. The other number. To die.
To be dead.
To die, to be dead. So the word mortal literally means to die, man. To be dead.
To metaphorically, to be spiritually dead.
Damn.
Man. All right, let's go to the word immortal.
Immortality.
Okay.
Because actually, we're actually in immortal right now. Because we got the knowledge.
Right.
So we're not spiritually dead, man.
Right.
But let's go to the word immortality.
Immortality.
Uh-huh.
This is the their definition. Incorruption.
Right.
Perpetuity.
Right. Incorruption. What?
Perpetuity.
Uh-huh. Read it again.
Oh. Perpetuity.
Yeah. All right. Which means what? To continue.
Yeah.
Read.
Purity.
Sincerity.
Uh-huh. Incorrupt.
So we're not gonna have them incorrupt. Them corruptible bodies. Read. Now go. Go to the Strong's.
Strong's definition. Incorruptibility.
This is immortal. Read.
Strong's definition. Incorruptibility.
Uh-huh.
Generally unending.
Generally unending. Read.
Existence.
Generally unending existence. So we're gonna so them immortal bodies, man, we're gonna live forever. So when it first came out, we said we're gonna live 1,000 years. No, we're gonna live forever.
Ye are gods.
Yeah, ye are gods, man.
Yeah.
We're gonna live forever, man.
Hey, get that.
But
He said, these be they that put off the mortal clothing and put on the immortal and have confessed the name of Yahweh.
Yep.
Now, are they crowned?
Hey, only way you can put on the immortal clothing left you confess the name of the Most High and His Son, Yahweh Shai.
That's right.
Put them together.
In the name.
Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shai.
That's right.
All right.
Matter of fact, that shit could say.
Hey, that's the only way you're going to put on the immortal clothing, man. Go ahead.
Khan, he said, now are they crowned and received palms?
Uh-huh.
Then said I unto the angel, what young person is it that crowned them and giveth them palms in their hands? So he answered and said unto me, it is the Son of Yahweh.
So I wonder, so that scripture cut them niggas. So I wanted to do them Old Testament Israelites believe in the Apocrypha.
Yeah,
did they believe in the Apocrypha?
Yeah, because that was part of
it. Because I know that's part of the Old Testament. Did they disannul it?
Yeah.
Go ahead. That's a cut. Go ahead, brother.
He said,
Was there any more to that?
Yeah, Con.
Go read.
He says, then began I greatly to commend them that stood so stiffly.
Yeah, so that's the whole thing of our trial. Our test. The outward temptation is what? Standing so stiffly.
Nothing being able to pull you out of
it. You got that in Romans? Get that in Romans.
So like it's a little bit more than this, brother. He said, who stood so stiffly for the name of the Lord. Then the angels.
Hey, you ever watched them, those police over there in Europe?
Soldiers.
They don't move with the big ass hats.
Hey, matter of fact,
you do all this shit.
Soldiers.
Hey, man.
Yeah, you fuck with
they don't blink or nothing, man. Hey.
The soldiers that called
the
Royal Guard.
The Royal Guard. Yeah.
That's how we is for Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shai, man.
So, hey, get that in Romans, man.
The Royal Guard.
It's about to expound upon it. Read.
Praise God.
Is it chapter 8?
Is it 8, brother?
About 38.
Yeah, yeah, brother. Yeah. Read up. Read from 36. Read from 36.
Book of Romans, chapter 8, verse 36. As it is written, for thy sake we are killed all the day long.
Uh-huh.
We are accounted as sheep for the slaughter.
Which we are, man. Because, hey, look at us, man. We just out. Hey, anything can happen to us, man.
Right, yeah.
We just counted as sheep as the slaughter, man.
Roll up.
You know?
Right, yeah, that's right.
And this was Paul. He was quoting this, you know. Think this is written in a book in Isaiah. We just counted as what sheep as the slaughter. Read.
Nay, in all these things, we are more than conquerors.
Yea, he said, nay, in all these things, we're more than conquerors, man. All right? Because, hey, he's right, because eventually we're going to become gods. All right? Read.
Through him that loved us.
Right. Through him that loved us. Read. Who's this talking about? Yahweh Shai, man. All right? Yahweh Shai told Yahweh, he says, glorify them as thou hast glorified me.
Mm-hmm.
So that, that's some, you know, somebody that love you is saying. Because here you go, Yahweh Shai, he can take all the praise for himself, man.
Yeah.
But when you read that John 19, he was lifting us up, man.
Yeah.
He say, hey man, they're in the world with your name, glorify them, you know, let them be on one accord as we are.
He's our Lord.
Yeah, he was praying to the Lord that we get the glory that he got, yeah. And we be on one accord like they are, man. Right, like him and the Father is, man. Read.
For I am persuaded that neither death.
Yeah, Paul said, I am persuaded that neither death, all right? Read.
Nor life,
this present life we have, man. This shitty life we have.
That's right.
Can what?
Nor angels.
Not even an angel, man. You know how powerful the angels are, man? Read.
Nor principalities.
Nor governments, all right? People on high, read.
Nor powers.
Hey, because the principalities, they don't come for us, man. So nor powers, read.
Nor things present. Nor things
present.
Present. Nor things to come.
Uh-huh. Nor things to come, read.
Yeah, what's present though? Your woman, your kid. Yeah,
that's right.
Your job.
Yeah, that's right.
You know what I'm saying? Everything that's sustainable on this side. The things that are present, man.
That's right.
Hey, you gotta be willing to give it all up, man.
That's right.
You know? Because it's a greater what is that? Far more an eternal way to glory.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying?
Well, Jake, you know Jake always got to say it get greater later.
Yeah,
it get greater later.
Yeah. True, man.
Yeah, which that's true. Yeah, it's a scripture.
Go ahead, Pops. What you got? Right,
you get greater later, man.
Yeah, here it goes. This is 2 Corinthians 8:9.
Uh-huh.
For ye know the grace of our Lord Yahweh Mashiach, that through he was rich, that though he was rich, yet for your sakes he became poor,
uh-huh,
that ye through his poverty may be rich.
Yep, that's right.
Yeah. So we like you said, we just trying to be joint heirs.
That's right.
Trying to get that kingdom in that same penny.
Right.
Yep.
Hey, Yahweh Shai,
go ahead.
Hey, Yahweh Shai built the earth up, man, and came down in the flesh as a peasant, man.
Yeah,
that's
right.
On the run, man, as a child, man, as a baby.
As a child,
yeah, man, as a child, right. Yeah.
That's it. On the run, as a baby, man.
He said, birds have this, foxes have that, but the Most High don't have this. He can lay his
baby, bro.
Go ahead.
Go ahead.
Was there any more pop?
No, go ahead.
Go ahead.
Nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come.
Nor things to come. What's coming? The chip, martial law, famine, disease. Nor things to come, Marie.
Nor height.
Nor height.
Nor depth.
Uh-huh.
Nor any other creature.
nature shall be able to separate us from the love of Yahweh.
So Paul said none of these things can separate us, man. Now, basically, Paul said not a damn thing can separate us, man. Not a damn thing.
You know what's good?
Scripture says, what's to separate us from Yahweh, man? You know, family. Get that, man.
That's what we read.
Oh, damn, that's Corinthians.
No. Romans. Romans.
Yeah, come on.
I know. Hey, shall man, you're going to look bad, Nicole. Your brain freeze.
Shall be able to separate us from the love of Yahweh, which is in Amashiach, Yahweh Shai, our Lord.
Yep. Uh-huh.
Mm. Keep going. That's it, all?
No, that was it.
Hey, man, that's what mind state we got to be in, man.
Yeah.
Hey, man, fuck with this devil coming with, man. Hey, we done suffered that before, man.
That's right.
We done been through slavery, man.
That's
we done
right.
been hung before,
that's
man.
That's right.
Now it's time. Hey, now it's going to be his turn, man.
That's
but you
right.
know what? Hey, he gonna bring that time of Jacob's trouble, but you're not supposed to be afraid of that, man.
That's right.
You know? Hey, man, we got the name of Yahweh Shimei was shot, man. Hey, that's power in that name, man.
That's right.
That's
the key.
Hey, man, you gotta believe that, man. When these things are coming, man, you got to believe the things that the Lord wrote unto us, man. The things that these brothers are teaching, man.
That's right.
Hey, man, brothers got to go home.
The scriptures say they got to believe he is.
Yeah,
he
man.
Is, right? He is,
yeah.
man.
Yeah, any man come to Yahweh's side, they must believe that he is.
That's right.
Hey, man, they got to believe, man. You know, what else do you have? A little penny-andy job and, hey, man, a little brown picket fence.
Little bitch.
You ain't even got the money to paint the fence white.
Con. That is the truth, brother.
Hey, man, these things, these set perils are coming fast, man. Right now, it's an all-out spiritual warfare going on right now in our minds, man.
Right.
And from day to day, man. These demons, man, are being very consistent, man. Very consistent in pulling and prying you away from your obligation, man.
That's right.
But what you got to do, you got to fight, man. Salakia, man.
That's right.
I'm just, man. Hey, the spirit, man. That's what the spirit. I'm preparing myself, man. That's what I'm thinking from day to day, man. To keep my mind right, man.
Right.
Cause these demons are coming. They're not slowing down, man.
Apostle Paul, he said, "Fight the good fight."
Yeah, man.
You know,
faith, man.
Yeah, fight the good fight. So it's a constant fight, a daily battle in your day to day life, man. You know.
That's what you're fighting.
Go ahead, Pops.
John 4:23 But the hour cometh, and now is when the true worshipers shall worship the Father in spirit.
That's true. Read.
Which shall worship the Father in spirit and in truth.
That's right.
For the Father seeketh such to worship him. So
that's
like
right.
That brother was saying, you know, you got to get your, as the songs say, as we in the black community, we already know, you got to get your mind right.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah, I know.
GMS, get your mind right, right, baby.
Yeah, you got to get your mind right, man. You know, like I said, and this, like the brother said, man, you know, all these things and all these prophecies and all the stuff that's going to come down the pipe, he give you that aforetime. So that you'll know, so you can understand it. You don't just meditate terror on your enemies. You meditating what your enemies could wind up doing to you.
That's
so
right.
So you gear. It's like, what's the most you can do? What? Peel my skin, do this, do that.
You locked in.
This body is done. This body is done. Fuck it.
He marked himself.
The 2:30 marked itself. Like I said, if he came out here two weeks ago, so he'd have saw Issachar standing out here with us. Okay, so now what? So this is all I'm saying. All he did was mark himself. Okay? Because when the Most High is destroying these motherfuckers, and he's put and he's that he's getting them that download while he's destroying them. All that shit that they said, it's going to be scriptures that's hooked to it.
But you know what? That nigga is right. Jesus Christ is his Lord and Savior.
That's it.
He's right.
He is. And that's right. Why he gonna burn up with the motherfuckers.
Hey, you know what? Hey, let Jesus Christ stand up.
Don't even get mad at him.
I ain't mad.
Jesus Christ is his Lord and Savior. But we gonna see how much Jesus Christ gonna save his ass. Jesus Christ gonna have a nigga in the concentration camp.
Hey, let Jesus Christ stand up and save you, nigga. Yeah. When these martial arts troops coming, man.
So that scripture. Let them save you.
Exactly. When this cracker is ripping your asshole apart, man. Going up in you like a woman, man. Call on Jesus Christ then, nigga. Man, this shit is gonna be some deviant shit going on, man. Men are gonna be getting raped like women, man. Hey, just to show you I'm telling the truth, back when we came over here, they had what's called buck breaking, man. What a white man, the so-called white man, would rape the so-called Negro in front of his family, man. Yeah. So, hey, that's coming back, man.
Oh, yeah.
Hey, it's going to be even worse this time, man. Yeah,
no, these crackers have lost their mind, man. Linebacking off what you said, I stopped there to get some gas and whatnot. So I got my gas, put $15 in. You know, I'm sitting there getting ready to hit the road, coming back home. So I wanted to try to link my phone to my stereo. So if I pick up some music, maybe listen to the Apostles or whatever off the internet. All white motherfucker, right? It was a little space between my car and that big ass van or whatever truck that he was driving. He gonna come and get out of his van and walk around and ask me, what you sitting there for? I had to look around like, who the fuck is he talking to? Oh, motherfucker. I had my gloves on. I'm like, I'm gonna have to take these off because I can't beat him down with these because he's too old for that. I mean, old motherfucker is like, for real? I'm telling you,
bro,
man.
All you had to do was jump at him. He'll break himself to pieces, man.
Look. This truck tequila. Yeah. He's got motherfuckers juiced, man.
Yeah, man.
Come on, man. Let's get back to the scriptures, man.
They doing Trump shots, man. They riding around with a bottle of Trump juice in their motherfucking
truck. What you got, brother?
Talking shit. Yeah. Go ahead,
Revelations 3:11.
Go ahead.
Revelations 3:11. Behold, I come quickly. Hold that fast which thou hast, that no man take thy crown.
Yeah. And that's what we're striving for, man.
Hold this knowledge. All right.
Hold this knowledge. And we're trying to actually receive a physical crown.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
All right. Greet.
Him that overcometh will I make a pillar in the temple of the Most High.
Overcome what? The shit that's coming to this present world, man. All right. Like it, what's that? I think it's in John, say, little children, you have overcame the devil. All right. That's what we trying to overcome, man. All right. Being in this present world, man, and ultimately making it to the kingdom of heaven, man. That's why we out here, man. We ain't out here because we want to seem cool.
Con.
You know. Yeah, we want to be saved, man.
Con. Give diligence to make your calling and let you know. Sure.
Greet.
And he shall go no more out, and I will write upon him the name of my power, and the name of the city of the Most.
You know what, man? It's like wherever you go in the scriptures, you can't escape name, man. you can't escape that word, man. You can't escape it. You gonna see the word name everywhere, man. Name. You can't escape it, man. I don't see how Nate and them read the scriptures. Because everywhere you go in the scriptures, say name. How the fuck they even read the scriptures, man?
They don't, sing man. They
God don't. Damn, man.
They don't read the scriptures, man. They believe what Nate tell them.
They could read, because I'd be like, well, yeah, they go to word name again. They go to word name again.
Only can be saved by the name.
By the
name. They too busy trying to look good.
I got
to read the scriptures.
It's Romans 10:13.
For whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
How then shall they call on him in whom they have not believed?
Oh,
and how
they just explained
that's
it.
That's right, man.
They just explained it.
Yep.
So they don't even believe in Yahweh Shai. They say, how can they call on him for whom they not believe?
Yeah.
So they believe in him in the first place. Go ahead, bro.
Notice the word name is singular,
that's
man.
Right, brother.
It's not names.
It ain't plural.